This is the Awesome Life Podcast.
I'm awesome. Team Awesome.
You're rocking with Mr. Phoenix.
And Lynx. A good portion of this, the episodes of this podcast have some sort of graphic sexual language involved at some point.
Yeah.
We always be talking about busting a nut or anal sex or something.
Remember, there's a fine line between a really big clit and a really small dick. And he's got the biggest clit in the world. This beat again.
Bro, this song, I'm tired of the beat was hot for a minute, but I'm tired of it.
Well, we had to do it.
We may as well just kill it while it's still hot.
Shit. He's not hot, though. Like, he's got buzz, whatever.
Whatever.
We're going to do a shmoney dance on the podcast.
Let's do it.
Jello Beats, holla at me.
They call me Phoenix because I'm hot, nigga.
Hot.
They call you Snow because you not, nigga.
Yeah.
On point, yo, like an icicle. And you chick on me like a price sticker. We about to blow. You hear the time ticker.
Woo.
You can find me in the ER because my rhyme's sicker.
Yeah.
Never going back home like LeBron, nigga.
Yeah.
Stay with my team for life, nigga. I don't trust niggas cause they sell out.
Sell out.
And I don't trust bitches cause they bail out.
Bail out.
Fuck all y'all wanna ball out. So I'm just gonna rock out with my cock out.
You already know where the trouble at. Bitch, I get it popping like some bubble wrap.
Rap.
I don't shoot just once, nah, I double tap. You can never keep me quiet, take the fucking muzzle back. She say she a big dick connoisseur. I beat the pussy up till it's kinda sore. You rappers don't want me here, but I'm running you anyway. Till I'm balling like a bitch, WNBA.
Woo!
Yeah.
My nigga Lynx murdered it.
About a week ago. Yeah, doing the shmoney. We shmoneyed the whole time. Y'all can't see it.
We're just shmoneying
the whole time.
Da da da. Da da da. Awesome Life Podcasting. We don't got no raps for you. I'm just gonna sing a song. While Mr. Phoenix texts and keeps on texting, cause he's professional, so professional, cause this is the podcast, 30 seconds in and I'm still singing a song, I don't give a fuck, I'm singing a song.
Podcasting.
Awesome Life Podcast.
You know who you are.
You need to tell your bitches to stop texting you.
Stop, bro.
During the podcast.
That was almost a whole minute. I know I'm not going to be able to listen to this episode by myself because I'm going to just shit on that stupidity. That was the whole first minute.
Oh, man.
I think I'll just keep on singing.
Tell him not
the whole episode.
Lynx, come on.
My brother, fuck my brother. He's not the only one.
You a dumb motherfucker, I tell you.
See, you never know. You come in here maybe expecting bars, and look at that. You got a fucking beautiful serenade. The white Mike Shinoda.
A.K.A. Oh, yeah. Mike Shinoda is white, isn't he?
He's like Mexican.
He's half Japanese, half white.
He's half Japanese, half white.
Something like that.
Whatever. He looks more
white than me.
He looks more ethnic than he does white, in my opinion.
I don't know. Hearing that boy's
I don't know. His
Japanese
voice
is the funniest
thing
I've
ever. No, his voice
heard.
Is white, yeah, but
he
looks.
Fuckers.
He looks different.
Watching a live video of him, hearing him speak Japanese is the funniest thing I've ever heard in my life. It's like it's the worst thing you've ever heard in your life is the funniest thing I've ever
seen. I think
I'm
a racist because he's Japanese. I thought he was Mexican.
Well, there's this certain someone that I'm currently talking to right now.
Let's be somebody you're currently affiliated with.
Yeah, currently talking to. She's a special lady. I ain't gonna name no names. She knows who she is. She's probably listening to this podcast right now, feeling all some type of way about herself. Some type of way.
Well, we gonna cut that shit down right now, yeah, bitch. No, I'm just kidding.
And I ask her, where you get all that ass from? And she be like, fried chicken and milk. Her mom had cravings for fried chicken and milk during the pregnancy, so that's where she blames the booty on fried chicken and milk.
If my mom's expired.
My mom's dead. My mom's prehistoric.
I was going to say spoiled. Yeah. I feel like that was the next step after expired.
She's dead.
How old is your mom?
63 or 62.
Yeah, my mom's 40. She's turning 49 in a couple weeks.
My mom's on her way to being a great GIF.
Oh, God. Did you say GILF?
Yeah.
Oh, gross. GILF should not be a thing.
I've met a GILF, though, that's actually, like...
Well, yeah, a GILF that's, like, 38, yeah, and everybody had kids young in the family. Yeah, I've seen those.
I've met those. I mean, I'm not saying she looked, like, good or anything.
I'm saying,
Natalie's mom, she's in that age range.
Yeah.
She's...
She got a little.
Yeah. You're an asshole. Other than that, she's.
Nobody can see it.
That's fucked
up. Yeah.
I said names, bro. That's fucked up.
You shouldn't have said names. I'm going to blame you. Yeah, she became a grandma like 34 or some shit.
Maybe even.
Motherfucker, I'm 34 years old. That should never happen.
I got grandchildren.
You shouldn't be a grandparent younger than 40. You know, a lot of women will be like, oh, I need a guy with a sense of humor, but then they'd be too dumb to get jokes.
Yo, that is fucking true.
Isn't that, I never even, like, verbalized that before, but that shit is so true. Your ad-libs are worse than Young Thug's.
Yo, what is he saying? What is they saying anyway?
Saying go Phoenix.
Laughing out loud. Most these rappers are a bunch of jokers right now. Got a house of cards mentality and an ace up my sleeve. Yeah, I'm bad, huh? And I ain't never gonna leave, yo. Call me the one like Reeves, though. Call me a pussy, then I am what I eat, ho. These girls' pussies are easy like a free throw. Got them on point, they walking on their tiptoes. You want a big tip, yo? Is it cause you want my dick or did you hear I got that fucking stable, though? Willing and able, though. What I'm doing, get your chick on the table, bro. This is pay-per-view, it ain't cable, ho. Do it for the team, girl, and drop it low. They say I rhyme insane, well, so? I suppose a nigga got that crazy flow. The chick kill me with her head, she gets a fatal blow. Well, you ain't even know, but I really know. Your bitch ass being bitches and bitchless and witness. Your witness, my motherfucking wittiness, watch!
My opinion is that if you are going to believe something that is not ridiculous. Believe something that is believable. Believe something that has merit, not a storybook, which is what the Bible is.
I feel you on that. Yeah. Again, I feel you on that.
You have the right to believe whatever you want, but I personally feel that if you are going to believe something...
But that's your belief, though, and you're imposing that on
people.
I'm
not imposing it on anyone. I'm merely expressing it.
Okay, you're expressing it, and if they do not think the same way that you are, you deem them an idiot.
I do think that believing... I do believe that if you are going to believe in a book that was written by people and you honestly believe in your heart that there is a man in the sky that created everything,
in the Bible it doesn't really say the man in the sky. It's not like that.
Right. But there is a lot of stupid shit in every religion.
It's so true.
Yes. I don't even, I honestly
there's
don't.
There's positive things in the Bible, too. You
yes.
know that.
But
it's
what's,
not all. Just,
of course. But it's a good chunk of.
Listen. You know what destroyed my thought of the Bible?
What's that?
And God. It's called the Book of Job.
Yes.
Have you heard of it?
Yeah. Something you about know, patience, isn't it?
No. It's faith. But, yo. So, if God exists, right? And Lucifer, the devil, whatever, goes up to God and says, "Yo, I'm gonna test this guy out right here."
Yeah.
Your boy Job over there.
Your boy.
Your boy Job. He's been loyal to you. I'm gonna see how loyal he is. And yeah, God's like, that nigga loyal, bro. You can do whatever you want. He gonna stay true to me.
It's the hood version.
Yeah.
I like it.
Hey, he gonna stay true to me.
You should do an audiobook.
Yo, so.
Nah, my nigga is loyal. These hoes ain't loyal, but.
So let's.
But Job loyal.
Lucy. Yo, let's make a bet.
Lucy. IG.
Let's make that bet. I bet you that this nigga stays faithful.
This is great.
I bet you this nigga
segment where you just read verses out of the Bible. Like,
so what this nigga does right here, this nigga, the Lucius, this nigga says, "I'm a fucking take this nigga's crops." He's a super wealthy guy, beautiful fucking family,
yeah,
healthy, prosperous. First, he takes his fucking crops and where he makes his money. All right? Destroys them. Nigga stays faithful. Right? Then this motherfucker takes his family. Kills them all. Kills his entire family, bro.
That's terrible.
Nigga stays faithful. Then he takes his health. His health. He's like a leper or some shit like that. I can't remember.
Guy's trying to get that money on that bet, though.
The nigga stays faithful. And then after he stays faithful, he heals him, gives him a bunch of shit. Doesn't bring his family back. Gives him back all the other shit.
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Yeah, God.
He fucked this man's life
to win a bet.
To win a bet.
Essentially.
There's more fucked up stories.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'm aware. Nigga,
Revelations is the most fucked up story of them all.
That is
propaganda.
Yeah.
That shit is striking fear.
That shit
into everybody.
That story specifically.
It's like a political ad.
Yeah.
Nigga, if you did not accept Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and Savior, you are going to hell. And then when this serpent comes up with a fucking 1,000 eyes and you hear these trumpets playing, nigga, your ass is dead, bro.
Who's playing the trumpets?
I don't know. That's one of the things of
got an iPod on shuffle.
Of the apocalypse, you hear the hornsmen play, and then the serpent with a million fucking eyes comes up.
That's so weird.
It's crazy, bro. It's a creepy ass.
We need to do a segment where you read sections of the Bible, because that was amazing. Because Lucifer were like, "Nah, that's my nigga though.
I hope we get to keep all of it.
Yeah.
If it cuts out,
I love that. I like. God was like, "Hell yeah, you gonna stay, Lord? That's my nigga though." Why? You could kill his family, murder the whole squad. See what I care.
So, excuse me for that. If it wasn't entirely right, I hadn't heard it in a long time.
Right. I'm sure that's the gist.
It's basically, in a nutshell, that's what it is.
Yeah.
So that's what killed my Bible thing. But back to the topic at hand, and then we should segue out of the religious talk.
I try to avoid it.
It's just like, again, as someone who's not religious at all, and I don't believe in the Bible, and it's plain and simple. I try to like give everyone the benefit of the doubt, and if they want to do that shit, I ain't saying shit. Like, go ahead and do it. I ain't gonna call you out on it, no matter how ridiculous.
You tell me you ain't gonna call Scientologists out, bro?
For what?
For believing in a fucking alien?
No, I'm sure. I don't really like that. I don't approve of that religion.
Okay.
But if they want to believe in that shit, as long as it's not affecting my life.
No, I agree.
Or that's other people's lives.
Yes.
When the Muslims, which I have nothing wrong with the Muslims.
Right.
But when they're bombing.
Yeah.
Our fucking people, or even just people in general, there's a problem with that religion, because you're killing people.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, again, live and let live. Everybody can believe whatever they want. Personally, I think if you're going to believe something, believe in something that is something with some kind of a merit to it. And I believe at a certain, because clearly, if you do even just a little bit of research, religion was basically started for organization. it was started to keep people in line. And I think without religion, human beings may not have made certain strides in the past. So I think at a certain point, organized religion propelled humanity forward. I think now it's keeping humanity at a standstill. I think at a certain point, organized religion was very useful in creating progress. But I think it's gotten to the point where organized religion, not whatever you do in your own home.
Well, governments took over that.
I think organized religion is actually holding a lot of humanity back. Because
religion, religion was, the church was the government.
Yeah, at it one still point. Is. Like, they claim secular and religion is
yeah, but
separate. It's
but,
not separate. It's all the same fucking
but it's
thing.
Not the church, bro.
Yeah, but it's still all the same. It still says, in God we trust on our dollar bills.
No, I understand that, but it's
and
not.
They're tax
it's
exempt,
not,
which is
not,
bullshit.
It's not the church.
No, it's not, but it's all the same thing. The government likes, they like having religion around because it keeps people in line.
I guess.
You know what I'm saying? And that's really the whole, like, foundation of religion is to keep people...
Well, say, you give them morals.
Yeah, and, hey, you shouldn't do this because God won't like it, you know? And then, so they don't do bad stuff and they build things and do what you tell them to do. I had another thing.
Well, they make you take the oath and put your hand on the Bible.
See, how would I do that in court? I couldn't. Because I wouldn't swear on a Bible.
Then serve your sentence, bro.
Like, I...
Then serve your sentence.
That's
so, like, you're telling me your pride, so...
That's like, okay, whatever is going... If I'm being charged with a crime, let's set that aside. If I'm going to testify in a case, I can't do it. Because I can't put my hand in the Bible and swear that I won't lie on a Bible because I don't believe in the Bible. Right? Like, if I tell them, look, I can't swear on a Bible...
There might be repercussions for,
like,
that.
Like, you're gonna make everyone swear on a Bible?
They do.
Who gives a shit? What does that even mean?
But here's the thing: if it doesn't mean anything, just fucking do it and just
get
over
with. Yeah, but that's the problem. That's why shit like that gets to
stick around,
be perpetuated, because nobody makes us think about it. It shouldn't.
If you saw a murder, right?
I can't honestly say what, but I would tell them, I'm not willing to swear on a Bible, because the Bible means nothing to me. So I can put my hand in a Bible and lie and not feel shitty about it.
But if that's the case, then what? Why not?
Because it's about.
It means nothing to you. So if it
exactly
means nothing,
it,
so
though.
It's nothing to say.
It's not.
It's nothing.
It's
nigga.
Stupid.
It's nothing.
Like, if you think about it, it's like a contract that doesn't exist. Think of, you know, like, don't lie on this Bible. Like, what the fuck? It's like, don't tell me, don't. You might as well tell
so
me not to lie on a cookbook. It's the same fucking thing.
Yeah, I feel you.
On an encyclopedia.
But honestly,
it's not. It's like that with anything. Like, you could get an amazing job, and you're still gonna have shitty days. Like, you can have, you. We could blow up. Awesome Life Entertainment could become huge, and shit's. Some days are still gonna suck.
Course.
Some days you're gonna wake up and it's still gonna suck.
It's not gonna be one. It's
you know,
not Wonderland.
We'll put out a podcast. We might have a million people downloading it, and we might have 1,000 comments that say this podcast sucks dick. You know what I mean? If there's a balance to life, and you
might get death threats.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised
if
you
saying,
got.
Were you saying nigga?
I don't give a fuck.
But it ain't enough.
You should have.
So
went
I got
in there
at
and,
her mom.
You should have went in there and did that character. Just been like, yeah, I fucked her. I don't give a fuck. Just don't open your mouth at all. Yeah, I got a nut.
I got.
You asking me why I want to be on
the
real
the
world?
The two girls that were interviewing were bad too.
Yeah, of course.
I should have been like, what did I smell like?
You want to know why I want to be on the real world? Because I ain't got no money, nigga.
And you better give me that money.
You going to get me on TV or give me a fucking paycheck, nigga.
Oh my God. I can't stop laughing.
So I got in my car, right? I drove here.
I had no money, so I borrowed it from my mother.
Yeah. I borrowed the money. I don't even got gas to get home.
So I parked the car legally because I ain't got no money.
Oh, cracking myself up. My boss probably going to fire me, but I don't give a fuck. So I hate my job.
So what you doing later, baby?
Oh, God. You need to let me on the real world because I'm the realest motherfucker on the planet.
Let me go on the real world.
Let me on the real world because I'm the realest. Ain't nobody realer than me.
And this bitch that be fucking other bitches, fuck her. That unfaithful ass bitch.
She came home and told me, if my girl came home and told me, I fucked your sister, I'd be like, that's a mistake. You better not have no sister.
I bet I had no sister.
Bitch, that's a mistake.
How you gonna fuck my sister? Bitch, I don't even have a sister.
Oh man, that was.
I tell a bitch, give me a chicken sandwich and some waffle fries for free.
Cause I ain't got no money.
we gotta end this.
That's one of my favorite lines. Like, cause I ain't got no money.
And you gonna give me all the money you got? What is that?
that's enough for me.
We've had enough, guys.
This is an awesome life podcast. Give us some money. We got no money.
We got no money.
I had a shitty ass mic stand and I'm mad about it.
You thought you were gonna get something real? Not on this podcast. Cause I don't got no money.
Why the fucking fans so loud? Why can't we fix that shit? We ain't got no money. Buy a t-shirt cause we ain't got no money.
Unforgivable.
That's totally the name of this podcast. I can't wait to listen to this shit back and laugh about it with my niggas.
Dude, you know what I gotta do?
What?
I gotta go get some pants for me and my niggas.
I went to the mall today to get jeans, and I told Crystal, I was like, oh, I gotta leave. She's like, what are you doing? I was like, I'm going to get some pants for me and my niggas. She's like, did you just say getting pants for you and your niggas? I was like, you need to watch the video, bitch.
Yo, we gotta hope that this comes through. I'll be totally
upset. You ain't never watched that video. That's a mistake. It's so old, but it's still so funny.
Hey, this day, get some pants for me and my niggas. I ain't had no money.
I was
a girl there trying on some skirts. I was like, what that smell like? She was like, she didn't know what to say. I was like, bitch, don't make me ask you again. Anyway, got her number. The next day we went to Chicken Filet, some place in the mall.
Chicken Filet.
When I got there, I was like, bitch, where all these people out here? She said, well, it's the mall. I was like, whatever, bitch, give me a chicken sandwich and some waffle fries. I was like, bitch. She said, what you gonna have to eat? I was like, go up there and just give me a chicken sandwich with some waffle fries.
Yo, we gonna pause this right here. We can't play the whole video. We gotta end this.
That was fun. Yeah. All right. SoundCloud, Twitter, Instagram, Awesome Life ENT, YouTube, Team Awesome 305. For me, SoundCloud, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Links does it all. I just dropped a new song like an hour ago. Also.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
When's the tape coming?
I've dropped every song but one.
For real?
Yeah, there's like, when I drop the tape, it's like, oh, cool. Every song we've heard before plus one new song.
Well, why don't you just drop the fucking
one? I gotta finish the song. But I'm so tired of waiting.
You ain't got no money.
She was lying, got no money to put on no mixtape. I was like, bitch, get my mixtape out for free.
You better not have no little brother.
Check me out on SoundCloud. Download the song for free, cause I know you ain't got no money either.
Unforgivable.
Alright, we told you where to go. You know where to find us.
You know where to find us, so go listen to this podcast. We ain't got no money.
You don't give me all the money you got.
Unforgivable. Like I was saying, nothing's ever gonna be all the way good, all the way bad. Understand that, and your life will be a lot more smooth.
Look, you know, you got a 98% good nigga.
That's it.
You need to hold on to that.
Hang on to that. Because
he might one day be that 100%. Because 100, Yo, the key to perfection is imperfection. When you appreciate shit.
I was going to mention that too. Not only is nothing ever going to be perfect, but without bad days, you wouldn't appreciate good days as much.
Yo, there's this band. There's this band called Fireworks. Mm-hmm. And in one of the songs, he says, without this bad knee, I wouldn't have a good one.
That's true.
And then, you know, my old boy, fucking 50 Cent. Sunny days wouldn't feel so good if it wasn't for rain.
See? Exactly. That's
joy
that's,
can't feel so good if it wasn't for pain.
Exactly. That's the balance of life. I can't find this shit. I'll find it next time. That's the thing that people don't get is, and honestly, I've looked into the science and everything of happiness, and that's one of the number one things that they say is you can't look at happiness as a destination. You
can't get there. You're not gonna
exactly
find.
You're
paradise.
You're never gonna be like everything is cool forever, you know.
Shit.
And that's again as it goes back to relationships, which is what we were talking about. No relationship is perfect. Everybody fights. Everybody has problems.
I think the problem with relationships is the partners. I mean, I've been guilty of it before, but I tend to not do this. And I'm not even just talking about relationships, friendships and shit like that too. And you know how I'm loyal to a fucking fault. I try to appreciate the positive things and look at the positive things instead of focusing on, oh, this is shitty, this is shitty, this is shitty, this is shitty.
Of course, that's how your mentality should be in general.
Because I want to have a good night. I want to wake up the next morning and be happy. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go to sleep resenting people.
Yeah, exactly.
Being upset.
Never
at
go
people.
To bed angry.
You know, like what the fuck? Like, shit's not promised. Tomorrow I could just fucking die, or the person could die.
You could die in the middle of the
night.
And
what I've had in the past, you know, is where people just focus on the negativity. You know,
that's hard to see through, man.
You're aggressive. You're stubborn. You're this. You're that. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, great. That's it. But do I not do this, 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 this? If you spent more time focusing on those items, then
you know
you wouldn't be upset.
What that is, it's not. At that point, it's not you. It's that person. If you look at somebody that's saying that, more than likely, they say that about everything else in their life.
Yeah, they
That's a mindset. That's just a mindset that people have, and a lot of people, honestly. Which I've done a lot of work in the last year, specifically the last, honestly, probably like 3 months of trying to better understand the world and mentality and your own life, and it's...
Yo, Wikipedia ain't gonna give you that, bro.
It ain't Wikipedia, son. But the internet is a beautiful resource.
Yeah, it is.
It's honestly the most beautiful thing on the planet. You can just figure out whatever you want. But...
You got porn.
Exactly. Number one. But I've been looking into it, and I've been understanding it, and it's... Fuck, man. I had it. There was something I was gonna say
today.
I was gonna say directly related to it.
Today.
What were you talking about?
Well,
there was something directly, literally, like I was gonna bounce right off of something that you were talking about.
I was talking about
bitches be tripping, basically.
they focus on the negativity instead of like I did this and that, da da da, and they only focus on the two things that
I had something.
And then you were like, I don't know.
Basically, it's all in the way you think. It really is.
It's,
you know, and it's
mind over matter, bro.
I know where I was going now. I just got it. The thing that drives me the most insane is the people that you're talking to that are spouting all this negativity live in America. Like, when you really think about that, like, okay, not to say there aren't shitty parts of America, because there totally
there
are.
There definitely is shitty parts.
But I can almost guarantee most of the people that you talk to that are bitching about how shitty their day is, have food in the fridge, have a bed to sleep in, probably have a car that they drive.
Or probably have people that actually love and care about
them. You know,
them.
And it's like, what the fuck are you talking about? What the fuck? What are you talking about?
This is how I see things, and maybe you agree. I wake up and I'm like, I'm alive.
Yep.
I'm healthy.
I pray to Jesus every morning.
Let's not go. I'm healthy. I got all my limbs. I got
your dick.
I got plenty of that. I got all my limbs. I think I'm pretty intelligent. I think I'm pretty intelligent. So I'm not like a dumbass or anything like that. No offense to any of the dumbasses, especially the one laughing on this podcast.
If y'all dumbasses, don't listen to this podcast.
So intellectual, it's not meant for you.
It's for intellectuals only. It ain't meant for
you. You know, but
except when you rap.
Yeah. I have money. I have food. I have a house. I have family that cares about me. I have friends that care about me. You know, I have a good life. I can't bitch about, oh, I don't like the way I look. I'm changing it.
Yeah. Because
I'm not satisfied with it.
Exactly.
But I'm not going to sit and cry about my life and how, you know, when I live a good life. You said the other day, the fucking AC cut on. And you're
it was an amazing I had like almost an epiphany moment, like
a revelation.
I was sitting on the couch, you know, I was watching something, but I had it paused, so I might have been fucking around on my phone or something. And you came out and you turned, I almost said cut the AC on. I don't talk like that. But you cut the AC on, and I don't know, it just came down on me, and I just felt it, and I was just like, you know, it sounds corny and it sounds like some hippie bullshit, but it was like, holy fuck, like, this motherfucker pushed a button and it got cold. Bro, if we lived in Florida and we didn't have AC, you know what it's like to live in Florida and have the AC broken and shit. It's horrible.
It's terrible.
It's the fucking worst, you know? And it's just like, we live in a time where, especially this time, dude, like, anything you want is like, you push a button. Push a fucking, like, you could have, we could have a pizza here in 25 minutes.
It's amazing.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
can't do that shit in Somalia.
And we don't even have to talk to somebody anymore. You don't even have to order it on the phone. You could order it on your phone without talking to a person.
Yep.
That's amazing. Like, that is, internet is in the air. I know that's a silly way to think about it, and you probably don't think about Wi-Fi that way, but there's internet in the fucking air, and you push a button, and guess what? You got internet.
It's amazing.
Like, those are just the things that, like, it almost seems like as technology progresses, people get more ungrateful. Oh. Which is like, I get it. Trust me, when the Wi-Fi goes out, I'm like, what the fuck is going on? But then I gotta step back and be like, you listen to what you're complaining about, you fucking idiot.
First world problem.
Yeah, exactly. Listen to what you're complaining about, you fucking idiot. Awesome Life Entertainment.
Fuck yeah, awesome, yeah.